Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. But in all likelihood, YouTube sees you there unless you're using some privacy-enhancing technologies on the internet. Right now, and for the last 20 years, I've been working on technologies to help people get private on the internet. And it's been a long and strange journey. This year especially, we've been hit hard by donation drop-offs due to the coronavirus pandemic. But we're slowly recovering. And we're going on with our mission to help Tor spread everywhere in space and time. To spread everywhere in space, we need to make sure that we provide privacy technologies for everybody in the whole world that everyone can use on every device they've got. And to spread in time, we need to make sure that the things that we build outlast us, so that if I get hit by a bus or if I retire someday, we'll still be able to maintain all of the software that we've been working on. David has talked to you already about our HSV3 work, and Mike's talked to you a lot about our upcoming scalability stuff. But there are a few other things we've done this year that I think might be interesting. One thing is that we've done a whole lot of work to try to help IPv6 reliability for connecting to things on the internet via Tor that support IPv6. And for better support for IPv6 only clients. We've untangled a lot of old strange code that relays use to detect their own addresses in order to give a better experience for relay operators who want to support IPv6. We also designed a system called Walking Onions that I hope to be building over the next year or two with the rest of the team. And Walking Onions is meant to really lower the traffic overhead that a Tor client needs to have to connect to the network. Right now, Tor clients need to get a complete list of every single relay on the network. That's bad enough now, but if we imagine growing the network until it supports enough users to handle the whole world, then getting a complete list of all of those relays would be completely intractable. So with the Walking Onions design, we finally have a system and a plausible design for not having to do that anymore without any drop in security. Another cool effort we've been doing that, again, this is a future-looking thing, is something that I'm calling ARTI, ARTI. It stands for a Rust Tor implementation. We're using the Rust programming language, which is much safer and much more productive than C, to do a nice, small, well-factored Tor client. And we hope it will be safer, easier to embed, and easier to maintain and hack on going forward than our existing work. Right now, exactly one person has used it successfully to connect to the Tor network, but I did manage to get it working with the Tor browser. I hope that by the end of the year, I'll get something that we can't actually recommend for secure use, but that does kind of work for other people besides me. And then, depending on our funding and resources, please donate, we might be able to work on already in the future. I hope that it will be the future of Tor development and the future of Tor clients in Rust. Who knows? Maybe someday the future of relays. Also this year, and a shout out to our sysadmin team for this one, we have migrated from our old Track and GitHub setup, which was awful, to a shiny new GitLab installation that is great for clients and people who need to be working with Tor and working with our code. We usually get back to account creation requests within 24 hours, and it has been great for better responses to volunteer contributions. So if you're interested in hacking on any of our stuff, why not show up, make an account, give it a try? Okay, that's actually all I have to talk about for today, although I could talk for a couple more hours if they would let me. But next will come my colleague, Alexander Fari, who's going to talk about our work, making it easier to integrate Tor into other applications. Take it away.